We are beginning tonight with firefighters getting the upper hand on the Pfeiffer Fire that is burning in Big Sur. It has now grown to just under 850 acres. The big news is it's nearly 75% contained. Almost 400 firefighters have been added to the lines, total of now more than 1,000 on scene. Mandatory evacuations remain in place for people in parts of the Pfeiffer Ridge community. A voluntary evacuation notice was issued this afternoon for the area west of Highway 1. That's from Fernwood Resort to River Inn. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen has been side by side with those firefighters as they've been planning. She's live in Monterey tonight with more.
Yeah, Dan, the best news of the night for neighbors living in and around this fire is this possible early containment. And some who live in Big Sur are already planning the tearing down and the cleaning up of the little that's left of their homes and property. But others are still intently watching this fire tonight, and they're hoping that flying embers from the wind that we are expecting to see tonight don't bring the fire to them.
I'm happy to say that we actually have about 74% containment.
Thursday at 1800, we can have this fire totally encircled with fire line.
Winds are expected to test Pfeiffer fire lines overnight.
You can see sustained winds in the 20-mile-an-hour range. The fire has not felt a wind like this at all for the last 3 days. Obviously, when it started, it was warm and dry. Really want to emphasize a change in the weather.
But an estimation of full containment by Thursday is a full day sooner than expected.
Crews did make very good progress last night and today, especially with the cooperation of the weather.
Homeowners gathered to hear that news first at the community meeting that's quickly becoming a nightly tradition. Howard and Toddy Barbarash are here with resilience. They're ready to find out when they can start rebuilding their home of 32 years.
We'll rebuild as soon as we can. We're going to start with meeting with our insurance people tomorrow, and we're going to rebuild as soon as we can.
The before and after pictures tell the story of the remote home they called magical with spectacular views. Now a picture they can't believe with just the fireplace left standing.
And the next thing we know is this picture we got of nothing. 32 years of memories, dreams, everything. It's hard.
It'll be at least another day or two before the Barbarashes and their neighbors can go back to what's left of their home, with firefighters still squashing flames and deputies watching for looters.
We only know of one crime that's been reported, and that was a truck and a camper shell that had been loaded by an individual to evacuate. He left the vehicle in anticipation of evacuating, went to sleep. When he woke up, four rifles and a handgun had been stolen from inside the vehicle.
In the meantime, Big Sur is working to collaborate and waiting to go home.
It's a magical place. It's going to be a magical place again.
And there are spotters working tonight looking for any spots that might start burning away from the current fire area because of the winds that we are expecting to see tonight. And there was one injury to note today, Dan. One firefighter injured when he slipped and fell down a hill. He hurt his shoulder and bruised his side. He was treated at the hospital and released and sent home. He will be okay. And that's the only injury to report in a fire line of about 900 firefighters. Dan.
Truly remarkable given the terrain. All right. Thank you very much, Brittany.